Just got done doing my workout and my walk, so I'm a little bit behind. Not fully, just a little bit behind, but we got some shit to talk about this Sunday afternoon. What's up? Like I said, y'all know a motherfucker behind. Like, damn it. Okay, I need to pause for a quick second because I left the vape over there. Hold on. Don't go nowhere. All right, we good. What's up, everybody? Look, your boy's slightly behind. Just got done doing a workout, going for a walk. I had to get cleaned up. You know, I can come on camera looking like I just got done working out and shit. So, give me a second. I'm mixing everything right now. Hold on. But I hope everybody's doing well this Sunday. All right, almost done pulling this drink. What's up? Hello. Okay, so we got quite a bit to talk about. I didn't put a whole lot in the title, but it's a lot. Cut the fool a little bit, you know. And thank you for inviting some people to come on over and see. Holla at a player. In case y'all wondering, that's allergy medicine over in North Carolina. The pollen map, before we get into it, how many of y'all, what's going on? How many of y'all have allergies? Like, are y'all allergies acting up? Do y'all have yellow pollen everywhere where y'all at? Because in North Carolina right now, it's bad. It is bad now. I'm just trying to see if I'm the only one. If I am, then it's all right. you got allergies too? Yeah, it's bad. It is bad. But it ain't gonna keep me down. It ain't gonna keep me down. All right, so enough of me trying to get everything ready. This is very unprofessional, but that's all right. So, you guys already know, we gotta start out with the heavy stuff first. So, starting off with the prayers. Weirdly enough, it's not as bad as it was last week. Okay, so first, sending up prayers to the family of Oscar award-winning actress Patty Duke. She passed away from a ruptured intestine. So she passed away, I believe it was 69. I apologize for not writing down her age, but, you know, condolences and, you know, sending out prayers to her family. I can't even imagine how that would feel, but I'm pretty sure a rupturing intestine and having all the fluids and everything, 69, and having just like all that stuff just kind of like flowing through the body, I mean, definitely a bad way to go. Okay, I was right about the age, thank you. And for this next person, I was hesitant to write her name down because I'm pretty sure half of y'all ass is going to drag her. But let's be nice and let's send up prayers for Miss Janice Dickinson. She was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. Now, I know many of y'all are pretty much just like, for the drama that she done brought to Bill Cosby, this is her just dues. But regardless, let's not repay evil with evil. And let's just send our condolences to Miss Janice Dickinson. Hopefully, she can get past this. Hopefully, her family is in good spirits. And we're going to leave it at that. I know a lot of people haven't, but you know, like I said, and it's one of those where I don't like just talking about, you know, black folk over here, but, you know, again, you know, sending out prayers and whatnot. So, good afternoon, and as we all know, now that I got that shit out of the way, let's move on to some entertainment. Now, I was a little shocked to know that Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles is filing for Chapter 11. All right, so they are filing for Chapter 11. Now, there was a certain hip-hop artist who was unaware of this and was floored when he heard the news. Now, this particular person happens to be Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg and Warren G, this past Tuesday, I believe, was outside of a nightclub when it was brought to their attention that Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles was filing for bankruptcy. Well, Snoop decided that he wasn't going to let that happen, especially because he's a regular there. So Snoop is planning on buying Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles to keep it from going into, to keep it from filing bankruptcy and possibly going into foreclosure. So kudos to Snoop Dogg. Oh, and I forgot to say, make sure you guys keep in track of who gonna have the ALNW of the week. Let me say that. But I was happy to know, you know, that Snoop was willing to go and do that. So shout outs to Snoop. All right. Moving on to the next. All right, so we finna go from some positive to something that is nasty. I did not. That must have happened this weekend. I know that, I think it's WrestleMania is airing tonight. You just about to leave Periscope. I know that I believe WrestleMania is coming on tonight, and I'm conflicted because I'm wondering if I should go ahead and watch The Real Housewives of Atlanta and then eventually get around to watching WrestleMania, or just watch WrestleMania. But at the same exact time, unfortunately, I'm going to watch what's up from Southside. But I'm probably going to watch The Households of Atlanta first because I do review that and I get views off of that and not reviews off of wrestling. So, but I didn't know and I actually missed the Hall of Fame. But all right now, you just want to see The Undertaker match. Honestly, I think that, it's been rumored that Undertaker was going to quit from wrestling because he works backstage. He's been working backstage for years. It's rumored that within the next couple of years, if not this year, he's actually going to quit. And I think they might let Shane beat him just to kind of push this thing along. But we're not here to talk about the WWE. Okay, that's another Periscope or, you know, sitting around us talking for another time. I'm here for Shane O'Mac, too. I'm here for Shane O'Mac. But let's move on to some fucked up shit. Now, how many parents is on here right now? And what I'm about to talk about really, it has nothing to really do with age, even though it's there. I just want to know how many parents is on here right now. I'll be watching those. Okay, well, this story broke, so HBCU professor has been terminated. Now, Alabama A&M University fired a tenured professor by the name of Edward Jones. Now, the reason that he was fired, I know you are, Sean. The reason why he was fired is because the staff had found footage on the school's laptop of him pretty much having sex with two black men that went to that school, and there's three different footages. So I'm assuming it's not a threesome, but is this professor having sex with one boy twice and then another one, but it's on the school's laptop. And this was found, and when it was found, pretty much they informed him that they were going to fire him because of this. Now, this is college. This is a historically black college university. This is Alabama A&M University that this happened at. And, he's filing countersuit because he feels that this is all coming out because he was going to bring to light administrative issues and concern. Now, before I give my opinion about this, because it's one of those where it's a roundabout opinion, I'm going to give y'all a moment because I need to hit this shit right here and pump this. Not your baby. Now we got a kick to it. So here's my feelings on it. First and foremost, and I don't want nobody to get mad, but these are adults. Even though these are, you know, late teens to in their early 20s, still somewhat considered adults, meaning that they are consenting. Now, it hasn't come out that they've talked to these young men, that they got their side of the story. We don't know if they were doing this for grades or, you know, what, like, we don't know, because it was probably a quid pro quo, probably a this for that. So we don't know what it was. Now, I'm not going to give these men a pass because I'm pretty sure they knew what the fuck they were doing. I got it. They steal your babies, and I got it that you probably gonna roll up on that ass and, you know, get him smooth straight the fuck together. But I'm saying, on one side, I mean I feel bad for these young men. Exactly. It's nothing new. But it's one of those where, oh my gosh, it happened at a historically black college university, and part of me, like, even though it doesn't matter, I want to know, like, really, what was the motive? Like what? I don't understand. But at the same exact time, I'm looking at this dude, like, you're filing a suit against the university. Like, bruh, you were wrong. You, like, there's no way around this. You were wrong. Not only did you have sex with these young adults, this footage is on the university's laptop. And you got caught red-handed. But this right here is to say to all the parents, even when your children grow up and even when you send them off to college, unfortunately, they're not safe. All right? I don't know if it was recorded off of there. I don't know if he transferred onto the computer and was watching it in between classes. I don't know. But this, like I said, this footage was on the laptop. And it's like, why would you... Very dumb. Very, very dumb. So, all I can say is, hopefully he gets what he deserves. And, yeah. I mean, not anything goes, but... But at the same time, I will say, you know, for the parents out there, just ensure that you are teaching your children some self-worth. And just letting them know that it's not worth it to sit here and give your body up. Not for a grade, not for nothing. It's really not worth it. Not in the long run. All right. But that right there was in some fucked up news. Let me see. I want to put some of the interesting shit on the back burner. Okay. So we're just going to talk about this, and then we're just going to move on, because there's really nothing to talk about. And as I've said, I refuse to bash Cat Williams. I will not do it on this platform or any platform that I have. But he was arrested and charged with disorderly conduct. Oh, yeah, you busted. 3 o'clock in the morning, where you been? But he was charged with disorderly conduct, and he's being held without bond. Because he was in violation of another bail that he was let out on. So he gonna be sitting for a while. Now, 17-year-old Luke Walsh has been charged as an adult. And he was charged with disorderly conduct as well. And he is being held on $1,300 bond. So, it was not that he's in trouble again. But the footage that came out of him fighting with a 17-year-old... Both he and the 17-year-old have been locked up because of that footage. So, just a bit of an update. Like I said, I refuse to drag Cat Williams because of this. I'm happy that they charged that little ass boy for this, you know, because everybody trying to make it seem like he was younger than what the fuck he was. But they charged his ass as an adult. So, $1,300 bail. I think it probably should have been more, but I'm not a judge. So, it is what the fuck it is. Now, let's do a redux. Now, we talked about Mariah Carey and her sister last week. I don't know. Only God knows. A psych evaluation, yeah. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, I mean, all we could really do is just, you, like I said, continue to pray for Cat Williams. And like I said, what other people, other media, other bloggers, vloggers, whatever, like I said, they can sit here and drag him. I refuse to do so. Especially knowing that there is potentially a chemical imbalance. I'm not going to do that. But what I will do is I'm not standing by my brother in terms of, you know, agreeing with what he did, but I'm not going to tear him down either. I will not do that, especially when I know that a majority of the world is going to do it for me. So Not going to do that. But we're going to talk about Mariah Carey and her sister. Now, I know most of you were here last week when we discussed this issue. And I think we all were in agreement on how we felt about Mariah Carey, her brother, her sister, and this whole fucking debacle. Now, I truly thought that I would not have to talk about this again. I thought we were done. I was sadly fucking mistaken. Why do I say this? Well, Mariah Carey's sister has recorded a video. I'm going to use my tablet as an example. Someone holding it like this, looking all the way fucked up. I mean, Lord. She looked like death on a damn stick. And is pleading, telling Mariah, do not abandon me like this. I need you. Now, how many of y'all want to hear the footage? Have y'all seen it? Because I can show y'all the... really? I'm trying to put up my tablet out of the suit, but I'm going to play it for you. I'm going to try to let y'all see it. Hopefully it lets me play it. You'll pass. So hold on. Come on now. Come on. Let's see. It's what happened when I try to sit here and show y'all technology. Okay. I'm going to give it a second to see if it'll load. If it won't, then we'll just miss this. But I've even talked to some coworkers and whatnot, got their opinion on the matter. And they feel that if you are able to help your sibling, regardless of what has happened and transpired in the past, you help that sibling. My response is, my family know my cutoff game is real motherfucking strong. You know, what you not finna do is you not finna go to the Blabs and sit here and say shit about tea spilling and think the shit gonna be cool, because it has been said and it doesn't wanna load. Okay, you guys pause. Let me grab the other tablet. Hold on. I want y'all to see it. Okay. I mean, like I said, my family knows my cutoff game is mad strong. And again, what the fuck you not finna do? Well, exactly how many times, but I mean, a lot of people feel that regardless of the fact, Mariah should help. And there was a time that Mariah's sister said she was going to leak a story. She's dying anyway, help her. Okay, because again, we all have differences of opinions. I'm just saying, for me, if I was in Mariah's shoes first time, she was going to leak a story. Mariah went and gave her money. Old girl went and still released set story. I'm one of those where, no, we're not going to do this. You're not finna sit here and play me. You're not finna sit here and play with me. And if you think that you finna come up on my name, you done lost your ever lasted fucking mind. Here's the, you know what? On some real shit, family does come first. But what I'm not finna do is, if constantly, and I've had to learn this personally, if constantly inviting you back into my life, if that's going to cause me more pain than joy, then I can't do it. Even if it's me extending my hand to help you, it might. But when you know that you've done all that you can do, all right, I think I got it now. Hold on. Come on, now play, bitch. Wait, hold on now. I'm trying to get it. Okay, I think that's it. Hold on. Maybe. Okay. Well, I mean, here's the thing. I love my brothers, but I think my brothers and I, we all kind of understand that we're not going to go and trash the other. It's just something that we're not going to do. All right, hold on. Really? Hold on.
Please don't abandon me like this. Orion, I love you, and I desperately need your help. Please don't abandon me like this. Orion, I love you, and I desperately need your help. Please don't abandon me like this.
All right. So that is, and they looped it several times just so y'all can see it. So, honestly, so I think the majority of everybody watching, oh no, ah, fuck me. I need to pause again to top off my vape and fail. I'm sorry, y'all. It's one of them Sundays. I'm sorry. Turn that off. Alright. There we go. So, I'm guessing everybody's saying that regardless of what is happening, we're going to choose family. And like I said, if I don't know if everybody is understanding, but her sister has HIV. She was a prostitute for many years because she was not able to work. Well, she didn't have any skills. And she didn't have any job skills, so she decided to go into prostitution. It is through the prostitution that she got into drugs and also contracted HIV. And for years, Mariah has given her money, tried to get her help to get her off of drugs and whatnot, has even went so far as to put, I think, her two oldest children through school. And when Mariah's sister saw this, she purposely went and got pregnant so Mariah could continue to give her money. And it was around this time that Mariah decided to wash her hands clean of her sister. So that right there is just the backstory behind everything, because Mariah is being painted as, you know, her sister need help and she's not trying to help her sister, but a lot of people not understanding that Mariah has definitely tried, you know. So I don't want everybody to think, like I said, because I'm not going to sit here and bring this story, and I know a lot of people didn't watch last week, and that's why I based my decision off what I said, that I'm gonna help you as much as I can. But there's going to come a point where I can't help you anymore, and I'm not going to inconvenience myself. Exactly, but at the same exact time, I'm not going to try to help you through your mess when I've tried, but that's also going to take money out of my pockets, away from my children. I'm not going to do that. I'm just not going to. Only advocating because she's dying? Okay. I mean, like I said, I can see now. Now, the only thing that I could see Mariah doing is if it was for hospital bills, yes. I would pay for these hospital bills. And that's it. But at the same exact time, her sister, when their father died, her sister got $1 million from that. Her brother is there too. You know, so why is it that Mariah has to be the one to sit here and flip everything? Oh, that's what she was saying, the medical bill. Okay. So that is the latest. And as much as I would like to think that I will not be talking about Mariah and her dysfunctional family next week, I think I might, because there's probably going to be some old shit to come up. All right, hold on. All right. So let's talk about one of our favorite people, you know, somebody that we sat here and went up for a little over a month ago. And it's always fun. So let's talk about Amber Rose, our favorite over here. Now, if I can take you back when we talked about Amber Rose silencing Kanye West, Kanyetta. When she hit Kanyetta with a two-piece, wasn't even nice enough to give the motherfucker a biscuit. Silence his ass with a two-piece. Yes, we talk about Mother Amber. Well, Mother Amber decided to come out with her own emojis. Now, we all know that Kim Kardashian came out with her Kimojis and broke the Apple Store, right? Well, Amber decided it was her turn. Amber decided to come out with her own emojis, and some of them were shading the fuck out of Kanye. You have somebody coming out of, I would assume it's maybe like a bedroom or a porta potty, maybe out of a door. I guess bottom part is somewhat naked with a rainbow coming out their ass. Yes, Kim came out with her own emojis and she broke the Apple Store. Like, she made bank off her own emojis. Like, kudos to her. I don't really like her like that, but hey. She also had some with the fingertip and the gloves and shit. Like, they punking us. I mean, yeah, they might be punking us, but I'll say this. Who is capitalizing off the Kanye Amber beef? It damn sure ain't Kanye. Not with that floppity flop of an album. But Amber is making them coins, and she's getting that money. So pretty much her Mother Moji app brought in over $2 million in its first day. Now, I would save that for the congrats, but I believe that this just needs its own shine. This cover wasn't good. So I want to say congrats. To Miss Amber Rose. You know what I'm saying? Hey, make money off the age. Make money however you can. It's lit. Okay, well, I mean, like I said, I stopped seeing it for Kanye a long time ago, so I won't be watching or listening. Now, actually, no, hold on. I gotta reorganize my notes right quick. Hold on. Okay. Congrats, mother. So let's talk about Miss Badu. So, it has been said a while back, or there were rumors that Erykah Badu had been messing around with somebody by the name of, I believe his name is Carl Jones. He's a producer and an actor. It's been rumored that they have been messing around and that Erykah was the reason for the divorce. Well, just recently, Carl Jones posted a picture on his Twitter of him and Erykah Badu booed up. Now, I'm all for love. That's my girl too, but I'm going to say this. I'm all for love. I'm all for love. But I'm going to have to ask. My thing is this. If Erykah knew that he was with someone, and again, who is he? But he's supposedly a producer and an actor. But what I'm saying is, if she knew he was with somebody, if she sought him out knowing this, and if she stole him away, we all know the saying that karma is a bitch. The way you get them is the way you lose them. So I'm hoping that this was more of a rebound rather than her swooping in and snatching him away from somebody. So I hope that's not what it is. I'm not one to jump to conclusions. I'm here for love. And I'm just saying, I just want her to be weary. I mean, we all know what happened, you know, with the fucking, the sister twins, you know, the sister wives, Tara and Amina. So I just don't want to see a repeat. Now, we do know that Erykah Badu is about that life. So I don't need it. I don't need Erykah sitting here trying to pop a hole. Just saying. Now, since we were just talking about hip hop not that long ago, if you guys have not been to the Facebook fan page for, you know, T Spinsful and all the T, please go over there. But I put a link to a SoundCloud for this next thing that I'm about to talk about. How many of y'all, because I say, you know, I know about it because, you know, I know a little bit of the struggle. How many of y'all have eaten Hamburger Helper in y'all's lives? I want to know. Cause I know I'm not the only one that needs some hamburger help around here. And my favorite, that's right, was the Oriental rice. Are you still with this? I'm mad they stopped making the Oriental rice. That was my shit. I loved the Oriental rice. They stopped making that. That was good. Oh, you like that stroganoff? I said hamburger help was the shit. Was that jump off, baby? Well, hamburger now on April 1st, Hamburger Helper dropped a mixtape. The mixtape was called Watch the Stove. And I can't make this shit up if I wanted to. And I mean, like I said, the first song, I forget what the title of it is, because I listened to it, I gave it a play, was trap music. Came off with I'm serious. Hamburger Helper then came out with a mixtape, y'all. You're watching the soap because you're watching the food cook, baby. I'm so serious. When you guys get a chance, go over to, you know, the Tea Spilling fan page and click on the SoundCloud. And just, or the link for the SoundCloud. Well, I mean, you know, here's the thing. If the Hamburger Helper glove goes on Love and Hip Hop, I mean, the glove itself gonna bring all the fucking raids. See, the Hamburger Helper glove is like Cardi B on steroids. Because Cardi B brought her follow. That's why this last season Love and Hip Hop did as well as it did. Let the Hamburger glove come on there. Gonna be shitting on every motherfucking body, baby. But the cover was even crazy. Like, when you guys get a chance, like, but have any of y'all seen the cover to the mixtape? Or has anybody else heard the mixtape? Or am I the only one? Yeah, I'm a mess. I'm just saying. We shut the shit down. Like, I mean, it wouldn't be no Love and Hip Hop. It would be all about the glove shit. I mean, hell, the glove would sit here and get yelled at by all the motherfucking men for figuring they motherfucking women. I'm just saying. Tell me if I'm lying. Tell me if I'm lying. Because y'all know I'm not. Y'all know I'm not. I'm just telling the truth. I'm saying what y'all want to say. Okay? Saying what y'all want to say. Glove and Hip Hop. Hey, you ain't never lied. But if you guys have not checked out that mixtape, like I said, it is free. It's on SoundCloud. You guys go to the Tea Spilling Facebook fan page. And check it out. And I mean, like, it's one of those where it isn't bad. And trust me when I say I've heard worse. And compared to a lot of the bullshit that's out right now, it's decent. And it's one of those where if you listen to it, it's one of those where it's funny. It's one of those where it's just like, it's so funny. It's slightly corny, but it's still good. So, just want to let y'all know, yes. And you would think this was a Facebook, like, if this was an April Fool's joke, this was a well-crafted April Fool's. Well-crafted. All right. So, let's talk about Mia Isabella. Now, for those of you who do not know who this is, she is a transgender adult film star. Now, she is mostly known for previously outing rapper Tyga and NFL quarterback Colin, I guess it's Kaepernick. I think that's how you say the person's name. Y'all know I don't like mispronouncing people's names because I hate for mine being mispronounced, but I think that's how you say that person's name. Well, you never heard of her? Well, hey, she is back at it again. She is now, or she has now outed Haitian-Canadian boxer Jean Pascal. And she did all of this on her Instagram. So she took a picture of her tweets and then captioned that at the very bottom. So this is going to be a real quick story time for y'all. And this is what she wrote. The most dangerous are the self-entitled with a bit of money. No sense of reality or repercussions for their actions. Be careful who you trust. At Jean Pascal Champ, every time I hear your voice or see your number calling, I relive the hurt over and over. But you hurt yourself. You lost me. I'm done feeling ashamed. I turn down your proposal and offer to move to Canada for a reason. I want to move forward with my life. And Miss Lainey and whoever the fuck the other person is, know what you did to me. I'll let you pass away with it, and still you pursue me, constantly intimidating me. Let me heal. Look at John Pascal, champ. You know what you did to hurt me. After 2 years of dating, you took advantage of me. I trusted you. Just leave me alone. And then, those were the tweets that she took a picture of. And then at the bottom, this is what she captioned on IG. The only reason you're not in trouble is because deep down, I know you really love me and couldn't handle other men dating me. Still, didn't give you the right to take what wasn't freely given to you by force. You lost my love and my respect after what you did. All I asked was to be left alone. Yet you spent my whole New York trip last week doggedly pursuing me. Why? You don't owe me, and I won't continue to be intimidated by you because you fucked up and dishonored me. Just leave me be, and added him again. Now, that's a lot of shit. A lot of shit. And it's a lot to be questioned. A lot to be questioned. First and foremost, I'm trying to figure out, if he knew that this transgender woman has outed two other people, and this is going to lead me into another story shortly, why would you therefore get with this person? Now, I don't know if he was or wasn't stalking, you know, this woman. I don't know. Don't really choose to know. But I find it to be funny that in a world where you can sell stories like this, and as she get paid, she didn't sell this story, but she simply posted it. So it leads me to believe that didn't nobody want to pay for it. But you go so far as to put this man's business out there. So you pretty much let the world know, for anybody that was checking for him, that he likes a tranny. Now, again, this is the issue with motherfuckers that kiss and tell. This is the issue. This the issue with motherfuckers that don't know how to play their position and keep their mouth shut. Now, if he was in fact fucking with her, has she given him warning like, hey, calm the fuck down? That's one thing. But still, when you close with somebody, if you really love that person or was cool with that person, whether it be a relationship or a friendship, personally, I don't feel that it's ever right to sit here and spray that person unless they spray you. And even then, I still don't think it's right, because if that person is choosing to act childish, let them continue to act like a child. Let them throw their tantrum. Let the spotlight sit on them for a while. And then after a minute, ain't nobody checking for that person anymore, and you continue to move on. But she went and outed yet another person. So one thing that I would like to say to Miss Mia Isabella is you might want to be careful, because loose lips is not good. And if you are outing people that have slept with you that probably did not want people to know they slept with you, it's going to make it hard for people who might really want to get down with you to even fuck with you, because they feel that you don't know how to keep your damn mouth shut. So even though some of y'all did not know who this person is, you do now. So my question is, how do y'all feel about this? Do y'all feel that she was right in outing this person? Is she justified by it? I mean, do y'all just don't care either motherfucking way and want me to move on to the next irrelevant bitch? I mean, y'all let me know. Okay. Now here's the thing. Now when you say down low, are you talking about a man that is with a woman but fucking around with another man, or a man turned woman? Or are you talking like, how exactly do you define it? Yes. Okay, but here's the thing. Now, we don't know if he was actually dating a woman at the time that he was having relations with her. We don't know. Okay. All right. Hey. You know, it is what it is. But at the same exact time, you can't help who you love. I mean, you really can't help who you love. And you know, if he was, in fact, doing her grimy and shit and stalking her and whatnot, like, that's some fucked up shit. But at the same exact time, I don't know. I feel the ways about her just putting all that information out there. But, you know, in the long run, she might end up hurting herself doing that. That's all I'm saying. You might end up hurting yourself in the long run. You can. All right, so since we're talking about one hoe that don't know how to keep her mouth closed. I mean, true. Let's talk about another hoe that don't know how to keep her mouth closed. Now, Miss Kareem Steffens, a.k.a. Superhead. She and that's what we're going to talk about. Now, for those of y'all who don't know, she was notorious, I believe, back in the 90s for being a video vixen, for being the jump off. She didn't suck more dicks. Okay, yeah, this shit, she didn't suck more dicks than some of y'all named motherfucking hot dogs, okay? She had more dicks inside of her. You know what? We gonna stop there. But she a hoe. Not only was she a hoe, she was a kiss and tell type of hoe. She decided to write up, for y'all who don't know, she decided to write a book and told everything. It was to the point where people was threatening to kill her ass because, again, you kissing and you telling, and now you making money off of our names. So you would think, and I mean, here's the thing. Let me be clear when I say this. She is a very intelligent and a very articulate woman. She won't take it back because she did the shit. Come on now. For y'all who didn't know, that was a Mariah Lynn reference. The original Mariah Lynn. But you would think that for people to know, and like I said, she's very intelligent. She's very articulate. She is known as a writer. She's been going around to, and I've even mentioned this a couple of trending topics ago. She's been going around to universities and colleges and, you know, kind of giving speeches and whatnot, lecturing the whole nine. But you would think that in men knowing how loose of lips she have, both up here and down there, that they would not fuck with her. But somebody, I say somebody because I don't know who the fuck he is. I did not feel like looking up his credentials. But somebody by the name of Columbus Short decided to get in with her. Now, apparently they were married. I say apparently because he's denied it. But she had receipts to back it up. Not really finna get into it. But allegedly, he cheated on her, okay, and she kicked him out, threw all of his stuff out, took pictures of it, put the shit on IG, literally just put it all out there. He decided to call her delusional, all of this other shit. She went on a Twitter fucking rant, put out like 10 fucking tweets and shit. Well, see, I didn't watch some of the yard, and I don't watch Scandal, but okay, he's on, okay, so Columbus Short, I don't know him. I don't know him, I really don't. That's why I say I don't know who the fuck he is. I didn't feel like looking up his credentials, but thank you for letting us know who he was, because I still don't know who the fuck he is. But she went on a Twitter rant, and then she even threatened to expose him. And again, I didn't. But again, it's just like, if you know that this woman has loose lips, again, both up top and down below, why would you therefore give yourself to this person? And then, you know, shit, and again, apparently he cheated, don't know the validity. But this shit has played out on Instagram and Twitter, and the blogs are eating it up. I'm just glossing over it to piggyback off the last story. But what I'm going to say is this. To ladies and men alike who are watching me right now, if you know that you dealing with an ain't shit motherfucker, if you know you dealing with a motherfucker that kisses and tells, if you know this before you get intimate with this person, I understand. I understand that the Lord changes people. Yes, thank you, Lord. It's on a Sunday. I understand that the Lord creates change, okay? But it was said you can't turn a hoe into a house, wife or man, okay? Because there are house men. You can't do it. You feel what I'm saying? Sometimes it's like you could take the boy out the hood. You can't take the hood out the boys. You could take a hoe out of a hoe situation, but there's still a hoe inside of her. So from a whore to a hoe, I'm just saying. She probably is, but again, if you know this about a person before you get intimate with this person, that is a sign to probably not get close to that person, even though they may show you something totally fucking different. But if you know by their track record that they kiss and tell, it's probably not somebody that you want to fuck with. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not gonna talk any more about it. Okay, I'm not going to talk any more about it. But since we're talking about motherfuckers kissing and telling, a.k.a. motherfucker, can we talk about bitch motherfuckers right quick, Kevin? Can we talk about bitch-made motherfuckers? Because I want to talk about a situation that really had me feeling some kind of way. Some kind of way. And this right here is going to be open dialogue. Just open dialogue. So, I got hip to this story. Now, I talked about, and I'm not talking about what I was talking about last week, but anyway, apparently, there's this guy named Nick Young who plays for the Lakers. He is in a relationship with Miss Iggy Azalea. She has been in the blogs and everything, but I'm not going to talk about Miss Iggy and all this other shit. Because I'm still trying to figure out how the fuck Iggy Azalea was selling all these motherfucking records, made all this damn money, and you press about what the fuck somebody think about you. I'll be sitting here laughing at these hoes every time I take my ass to the bank. Every time somebody sit here and says crazy shit about me on Twitter, I'll be sitting here. I will sit here and spend another motherfucking dollar for every damn. I'm trying to figure out, like, why are you. I'm about to say, with the money I got in the. You know what? I'm not going to talk about this weak hoe. I'm not. That's why she's not a whore. But I'm not going to talk about weak hoes. Anyway, D'Angelo Russell, a friend of Nick Young, had was with his boy, decided to, and I'm gonna use my other tablet to kind of play like his phone, kind of had his phone like this, recording Nick Young confessing to cheating on Iggy Azalea. Now, that's some fucked up shit. That's some bitch made shit. Now, maybe, he was trying to have ammunition for a rainy day. I don't know. I'm not here to justify the shit. What I will say is this silly-ass, simple-minded, two-faced-ass motherfucker decided that it would be a good idea to upload this footage of him confessing to cheating on Iggy Azalea. He uploaded it to his Snapchat. Uploaded it to a viral fucking source. Motherfucker, why? Now, eventually this video went from there to the blog of, I think it's like Famulosi or Famulosa, some, whatever it is. It went to that motherfucking site. Now, to kind of take a back step, it has been rumored and semi-confirmed. Yeah, and I'm getting like that. That's some fuck shit. But it was reported. Exactly. And we're going to talk about talking in confidence too. But it was semi-confirmed that somebody from Nicki Minaj's camp saw that video, pulled the video off of his Snapchat, sent it to the blogs to therefore be uploaded to give a little 1-2 punch. Actually, a two-piece of the biscuit to Miss Iggy Azalea. And it was at that point that when this shit all came out, that it was almost like, Lucy, you got some splitting to do, because now Nick Young is here with egg all on his face. Now, I'm going to finish the story, then we just going to talk. So this shit was put the fuck out there. I don't know if this press conference was held to talk about this or whatever, but it was a press conference. D'Angelo went to apologizing for snitching. This right here takes snitching to just another fucking degree. Well, see, first and foremost, it's one of those where if you're going to sit here and confess some shit like that, first and foremost, you need to know the company. Oh, yeah, here's the thing. Ain't nobody going to say shit. Ain't nobody. When I, if y'all was on Twitter, y'all, and IG, when I said there were so many fucking memes going out and around about this snitching ass, but y'all remember Empire, the first half of this second season where Lucius was in jail and was singing, "Use a snitch, bitch." There was a meme of that in reference to this motherfucker. Like, there were memes about this son of a bitch. And you have, and pretty much just like the whole kissing and telling I was saying with the two holes I just got done talking about, as a man, you have just alienated yourself because ain't nobody going to want to say shit around your ass. Shit, you could be walking around with your motherfucking Apple Watch, free publicity, they ain't paying for this. But you be walking around with your motherfucking Apple Watch, like, motherfucker be like, "No, niggas, you record, man, no, take that shit off, home, no. Show me you put that, man, turn that shit off, nigga. Let me see, put, like, that's how motherfuckers going to be with his ass. Like, nigga, where your phone, run that phone, run your phone, nigga. Oh, you got a pen too? You probably, man, nigga, give me that motherfucking pen, dog. Like, that's how shit going to be. That's how motherfuckers gonna be with this motherfucker, which is like he gonna walk into a room, nigga, blah, 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 and then it's gonna be so motherfucking quiet. That's how motherfucking quiet is gonna be with the motherfucker walk in the room, okay? Oh, no more friends. No more motherfucking friends. All because you was on some bitch-made shit. There is no... Here's the thing. Even though y'all know I'm Jewish and shit, I don't even know if Jesus could forgive. I'm trying to figure out, mother, is he worse than Judas? Y'all let me know, is that worse than what the fuck Judas did? I mean, Judas betrayed with the kids. This motherfucker said he put the shit on the intranet. I don't fucking know. Exactly why. Like, it was like, I don't know if he thought this shit would be funny or what, but it was fucking stupid. I mean, that goes against bro code and everything else for you to do some shit like that. Totally goes against bro code. So it was just like, you fucking up, man. And at the same exact time, you, like, for me, if I don't fuck, like, first and foremost, I'm that type of dude where even when I'm trying to get to know people, I tell people, and like I said, even if people hear this, it is what it is, but I tell people different shit about me. And these are all factual things, but I tell different things to different people. Because if the shit get back to me, I know that I told you this piece of information. So the fact that it got back to me, I know you fucking said it. So if I couldn't trust you with this piece of information that is minute as shit, I know I can't trust you as with shit else. So you cut the fuck off. Ain't shit else to say to you. But there's only a few people in my motherfucking inner circle, and I mean a small few, that I would tell anything deep, dark. Man, get the fuck out of here. Like, it's certain shit you take to your motherfucking grave. You don't share with not no motherfucker. And then again, if it was, if he was truly one of his boys, you won't tell no shit like that. There's some shit where shit Tamika be like, "Hey Ray, where the fuck James at?" Shit, the motherfucker was right around the corner last time I motherfucking saw him, knowing damn well he upstairs getting his motherfucking dick sucked by a bitch. But shit, he was at the corner store last time I saw him. You might want to go ahead into the mom and pops. He probably up there. As soon as she, nigga, she was just over here like, man, she was. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but those are real fucking friends. Just because you on the same motherfucking team as a motherfucker don't mean, you know, okay, we're done. We're done. I'm tired of talking about snitching ass bitch. I'm tired. Yeah. Cause I'm about to get worked up, but y'all know I got high potential, so I'ma just, I'ma just move on. Cause I got, one more story. One more funny story, then the last story is going to lead us into some congratulations, because we are done. We could. This is one of those where we could go to blab and just have a good motherfucking time, but you know, again, I'm trying to keep my blood pressure down. Keep my blood pressure down. Okay. So let's talk about, now, we talked about somebody else that is going through some shit right now. We all know of another black comedian that went through it a while back, Dave Chappelle. Well, Dave Chappelle is back in the blogs because Dave Chappelle did made a motherfucking funny. And somebody might not think that this shit was funny, but damn it, I think this shit is fucking hilarious. But we gonna talk about it, okay? So, Dave Chappelle had a stand-up. Kylie Jenner? Hold on, which Jenner was this? Yes, Kylie Jenner happened to be in the audience. Now, Dave Chappelle went to, was in this stand-up, was talking shit about Caitlyn Jenner. So, this is what he said. He was talking about, you know, the first, now, he was talking about Bruce and was saying, you know, I guess referring to him as Superman and whatnot, who was beating Africans, you know, in track and field back in the 70s. This is him talking about Bruce. Then he says that, you know, he knew something was going to change when he ran into Kanye West. And, you know, he said to Kanye, wild alone face, and Kanye said, man, you'll see. And then, you know, he pretty much brought the whole motherfucking crowd to their knees laughing and shit. Because it was almost alluding to the whole you'll see in terms of, you know, Bruce turning to Caitlyn and whatnot. Well, apparently, Tyga even laughed, but, you know, Kylie had a straight fucking face, and it's rumored that she might be pissed because somebody made a funny about her, father. I'm just sitting here just like, I don't see what the fuck the big motherfucking deal is. And, I mean, I got it. You Kylie Jenner, and, but your father underwent, a sex change, and he is pre-op. He is a national motherfucking figure. You really think anybody been talking shit about him? I'm sitting here trying to figure out, like, bitch, did you not watch the last season of South Park for, like, a good whole 3 to 5 episodes consistently? They said, if y'all have not seen the last season of South Park, go watch the last, because you got to watch the whole entire motherfucking season. Oh, they'd be expected. About halfway through the motherfucking season, you have Mr. Garrison semi-booed up with Caitlyn Jenner, showing Caitlyn with a fucking deformed ass motherfucking face, and every time Caitlyn Jenner gets inside of a fucking vehicle, she runs over somebody and just keeps on driving off into the motherfucking sunset. So my thing is, if you're not finna be mad at fucking South Park, don't be mad at Dave. I mean, ain't nobody. But I'm just saying, it's like, and she might have been mad that Tyga was laughing at the shit. But I mean, here's the thing: jokes is jokes, shit is funny. It's just that damn simple. Okay, cause shit, motherfuckers talk about my ass on the motherfucking regular. You got forums talking about my ass. Here's my whole thing: shit, jokes is jokes, shit is funny. It is what the fuck it is, shit. Yes, yeah. If y'all have not watched the last season of South, I'm telling you, every time they show Caitlyn Jenner getting inside of a fucking vehicle, Caitlyn ran over somebody. Every time without fucking fail. Every time. All right. So now we're going to move into this last story that is going to bring us into the congratulations. And then I get to say goodbye to you guys for the remainder of this Sunday. And then I got to get ready to start prepping shit, eating my lunch and whatnot, and then getting ready to tape for the Real Households of Atlanta reunion and the Real Households of Potomac, because that's the season finale tonight. So, there's this girl named Michaela Omer. Now, she, when she was 4 years old, got stung by 2 bees. It almost caused a traumatic incident, but she went from being scared of bees to trying to understand how bees work. And then she saw how bees help the, you know, environment, the ecosystem. So she then went on to make her own lemonade and using bee honey to, like, sweeten it and whatnot. Well, they had, let me find my notes here. Hold on. Okay, so her and her father was on ABC show Shark Tank. They walked away with a $60,000 investment for her lemonade. Well, guess what, you guys? This young girl, her business has now struck a deal with Whole Foods. And they pretty much have offered her a $1 million contract. I'm sorry, she's going to get, $1 million, but possibly more from Whole Foods. And they're going to put her lemonade. I got it, but here's the thing. They're going to put this lemonade on the shelves of 55 stores in Texas, Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Louisiana. So from having this idea to getting a $60,000 investment, now she's going to get paid at a minimum $1,000, but Whole Foods is going to have her product on their shelves in 4 states in 55 of their stores. So congratulations to this young black queen for, you know, taking an event that could have brought her so much tragedy, turning this into an opportunity. And even, and if I'm not mistaken, I think she, I don't know how, oh, she's 11 years old right now. So this incident of her getting stung, she was 4. She is now 11, about to inherit $1 million. So she went from getting $60,000 as an investment for this lemonade to now getting a payout of $1 million at 11 years old. So congrats to this beautiful young black queen. Congrats, congrats, congrats. Now, since we're in the, since we're congratulating, and like I said, y'all know that I love to end this on as much of a positive note as I can. We start out heavy in the meat and potatoes of everything. Is, I know anything is possible. The meat and potatoes of everything is the mess, but ending on a positive note. So that right there, that probably should have been the last thing that I said, but congrats to her. Beyonce, again, I always say this, y'all know I don't see it for her, but she has launched her new activewear collection called Ivy Park. And it's a 200-piece collection. So, congrats to her. I'm not finna buy the shit. I ain't even gonna fucking lie to you. But congrats to her. You know what? Make your money however the fuck you can make it, okay? Sean Combs, his son Christian Combs, is just turned 18. And for his 18th birthday party, he has signed a contract with Bad Boy Records. So, congrats to Sean's son. EJ Johnson, Magic Johnson's son, has snagged his own reality show. That's and it's called EJ and the City. It premieres on E. I don't know if his son is a rapper or a singer, but only time will tell. But has a series called EJ and the City premiering on E on June 19th at 11 p.m. So congrats to EJ. Make your money pimping. Make your motherfucker. He didn't went from being on a show with other motherfucking people to having his own show. Make your money pimping. Tyler Perry has signed a deal to develop programming on the Learning Channel. Congrats to Mr. Tyler Perry. All right, so he's sitting here, got his hands in many different pots, but make your money and continue to employ your own people. Congrats to you, Mr. Tyler Perry. And since we talked about Diddy earlier, he is also opening up a charter school in Harlem that is supposed to open up in the fall. So, good shit for Mr. Sean Combs, and hopefully he stays true to it being a charter school and offering free college prep courses and a school to the youth that is in Harlem. Congrats. I think her name is pronounced Aisha Curry. She is getting a show on the Food Network. So congrats to her, Food Network. I'm still waiting on my damn cooking show, but that's okay. I'm keep putting the shit on YouTube for the moment. But congrats to her for getting her own cooking show. I haven't, but you know, I believe that shit when I see it. I believe that shit when I see it. Tatiana Ali, she is engaged to her boyfriend, Dr. Von Raspberry. But not just that, they are also expecting their first child. So not only is she pregnant, she is also engaged. So congrats to Miss Tatiana Ali. Masika and Fetty Wap have just given birth to their baby girl. And just before Masika gave birth, I think like a week ago, Fetty Wap had a change of heart and is now doing the right thing by Masika. I don't know how old Tatiana is. I don't. I think she might be in her mid-30s, maybe. But I'm happy that Masika and Wetty Fop have put the shit behind them. They have welcomed this baby girl. 37. Okay, 37. And I don't know. I mean, he might want to get a DNA test, a little swap. But regardless, congrats to the both of them for bringing in a healthy baby girl. And last but not least, our favorite Hollywood diva, Miss Countess Von, is now engaged to her boyfriend. They have been dating for the past, or they've been together for the past 10 years, and he has finally asked her to marry him. So, congrats to Miss Countess Von. Again, y'all know I love love. I want everybody to be in love now, okay? So, and y'all know Countess been showing off their body. You know, she is still slimming down. You know, 10 years yet, but it's one of those where, I mean, if it works for them, it works for them. But, you know, I'm happy that they're making this thing official. So, congrats to Miss Countess Von. So, before we go anywhere, we got to talk about the loser of the week and the winner of the week. So, who do y'all think deserves the ale of the week? Now, I think... Now, my L is tied between the professor at, you know, Alabama and, you know, Cat Williams. And I'm saying that because, you know, I feel bad for Cat Williams because, you know, he's being held without bond. But then you got this motherfucker that, you know, professor sitting here, you know, fucking students and shit. But then you also got motherfucking D'Angelo Russell, who's about to be ostracized by every fucking body. But who y'all think deserves the ale of the fucking week? I don't know. But I think we all need to come to a consensus. The professor. and the snitching ass bitch. Okay. A two for one. The professor. I don't know if we're going to get a 2-for-1. I think everybody is saying that the professor gets the ale of the week. And I guess that I will agree. So the professor at Alabama A&M gets the ale of the week. And hope, and like I said, you never know. He might get rewarded with some jail time. And if so, night, night, and keep that booty hole tight. So for the W of the week, is this, now, I am going to say that it, to me, I think it's going to, I have three people that I think last week. I think that either Snoop Dogg might get an L for him taking, you know, for buying Roscoe's waffles or chicken and waffles. Maybe Amber for doing her own emojis and getting that 2 meal, or young Makalia Omer for her business venture. But I think our black queen Makalia Omer, I think she deserves the W of the week for taking such a small, like a tragic event and making bank. But what do y'all think? Little girl, Miss Makalia. Snoop keeping the black store open. Okay, so we got Makalia, we got Snoop. Okay. Like I said, we vote over here, you know. It ain't me just saying this is what it is. We gonna vote. Okay, I got 2 for Snoop. Okay. Okay, Makalia, okay. So we tied now. I need for somebody to break this tie. We tied. Like I said, I don't want to be a tiebreaker because I mean if I have to, I don't want to be a tiebreaker. Okay, I guess I got to break the tie. So I think that even though I would love to give it to the Black Queen, I do want to give it to Snoop because Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles is a landmark, if you will, and the fact that it was about to be out of the hands of Black-owned people and something that was about to be lost, and it is a staple and the black community, and even in black culture, because there have been a lot of prominent black people to shout out Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles, and for Snoop to, at the drop of a dime, be willing to sit here. Oh, you mean, oh, okay, yeah. Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles was filing for Chapter 11, And Snoop, when Snoop Dogg heard about it, he pretty much went and said that he would buy Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles to keep it from filing bankruptcy and possibly that business either being foreclosed or going to someone else. I'm glad someone stepped up too. So, I think that is it for this episode of Tabloids and Trending Topics with T. I think we all had a good time. Hopefully, y'all enjoyed it. I don't really think we had a lot of good topics this week. I think last week was more lit, but you never know. Maybe next week we might get a little bit more. So hopefully you guys stay tuned for the reviews coming tonight. Love & Hip Hop Atlanta starts up again tomorrow. I think this week the Next 15 has its reunion, I think this week and next week, I believe. I could be wrong, so stay tuned for all of that. Y'all know Empire came back and all of that good jazz. So I'm glad you enjoyed it. Mark, I hope all of y'all. Oh, it's tonight. I need to look into that. I need to look into that because I'm not going to record it. But what I want to do is once all these reunions are over with, is to get my family together. We all get on Blab and we all talk about all the reunions where we all can just sit here and literally just dissect it and just talk about it, you know. And I'm not going to talk about the Next 15 only because I got into it late, but you know. So again, you guys, thank you so much for watching. This video will more than likely be uploaded to YouTube either Tuesday or Wednesday, somewhere around there. So thank you guys so much for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and share. You all have a blessed Sunday and have a wonderful, wonderful day. And I will see you guys next week. See you guys here next week, same time, same place. All right, y'all. Peace.